Yo man, I have been reading the Gospel of John in the New Testament and I am blown away by the wisdom of this great Hebrew apostle of God.
Well, I'm glad to hear that you are finally reading the Bible, instead of spending all your time trying to be relevant, down at that crucifix-laden untucked dress shirt-wearing candle-burning mosh pit you call a church.
Oh yeah, bro, being relevant improves my witness by keeping me tight with the peeps. Anyway, the best part of John's gospel is when he destroys your hateful mossback view of the atonement by saying, "Behold the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world." Did you get that? WORLD, world. And now I will pause, as the plain meaning of the Apostle John relentlessly crushes your fragile hate-laden theology, like an angry white sow, spasmodically flailing atop a bushel basket of gilded holiday eggs.
Look, if world means every single person in the whole world as you claim, and the atonement of Christ was effectual, then the unavoidable logical conclusion is that everyone on earth is going to be saved. Absolutely everyone. The interpretation you call the plain meaning of that text is at odds with the numerous scriptures that teach the eternal punishment of the wicked.
You always say such things, right before you twist the scriptures, using exegesis and logic. You would be better off if you stopped using man's logic to interpret the text, and instead based your theology on the plain meaning of the scriptures, as all sound biblical scholars do.
Do you honestly think that you build your entire theology on the plain meaning of scripture?
I most certainly do. The only way to understand the clear meaning of the Word of God is to let the plain meaning of each text stand. Let God be true and every man a liar.
The Lord Jesus Christ said, "If I then your Lord and Master have washed your feet, ye also ought to wash one another's feet." Tell me, do you wash the saints' feet with water as the Lord Jesus Christ did?
No.
Why not? I mean, I thought you based your theology on the plain meaning of the scriptures.
Clearly, in this instance, Jesus is talking about serving one another in love, and not about the literal washing of human feet, which is nasty and humiliating.
But what is the plain meaning of that text? I mean, Jesus was in the act of physically washing the disciples' feet when he said this, don't you know? There is absolutely no basis for believing that the plain meaning of that text is anything other than the literal washing of feet, whether you find it nasty or not. So much for plain meaning in that part of your theology. The prophet Malachi said, "Behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet before the great and dreadful day of the Lord." Tell me, who was the fulfillment of that prophecy?
That is easy. It was John the Baptist.
But the text says the Lord will send Elijah. Did you get that? E-L-I-J-H, Elijah. Isn't the plain meaning of that passage that the literal Old Testament prophet Elijah would return?
Yes, but clearly we see from the testimony of Matthew 11:14 that Jesus taught that John the Baptist was the Elijah spoken of in the book of Malachi.
Oh, I see. So what you are saying is that the Lord Jesus Christ taught that you must compare scripture with scripture in order to rightly divide the truth, and that apart from doing so, the plain meaning method of scripture interpretation is often plain wrong. I could not have said it better myself. You see, my brother, without the systematic reconciliation of scripture with scripture, the Bible is an irreconcilable pile of contradictory nonsense. Or as you call it, plain meaning.
Shut up, heretic.